Hello and welcome to my Master's Guide to Power of Champions. This time with Yumi over here. And we are going to take on Gangplank. Now Gangplank has the Tailbreak Mutator that just gives a random one cost follower. And overall, if you care for him a little bit, you want to have some way to deal with the Swain over here. Swain will just have this physics unit. Want to pick some lifesteal up for the one to Nexus. Also want to pick up some hard removal for Gangplank, the Threat Way, big threat, pick up some vengeances, big challenger guys, optimal, maybe a rally effect or something like that. Just to make sure the Gangplank doesn't actually kill you, overwhelm you or anything. Jump in, look at our first power. Bouncing Blades is just great against Gangplank. We have all of these Powder Kicks lying around, all of these one cost units. Having a constant Blades Edge, one attack, deal one to anything is very, very strong. Really need those extra stats. All of the opponent's units are like all-ish. Bouncing Blades is just very, very good here. First fight, check a Taskmaster, starts with one less mana champ. Gets all of these extra one cost followers, which can be a little bit annoying if they add like elusives and stuff like that. However, usually it's not that big of a deal. Okay, we find our Yumi, we have now the Giant Spell on her with the 0+2, our 2-drop, but again for finding our Puro Fly, maybe we do that, no, yet, find our Blade's Edge, no need to throw it out like now, just player to help next turn, now we have our one spell mana, we can actually go for the spell mana kill on this. 1-1. Two guys. Fine. One summons the Sand Soldier, which is ephemeral, so it dies. And now we can use our banked up mana to prevent those two damage nexus. And let's just run out our Yumi. I have our one big guy who they constantly have to block from now on out. Take a Taskmaster, doesn't do anything here. Of course, they didn't activate the Plunder. Grant anything. Unblock. So, Yumi buffs. A Burning Sandhopper. We find just losing my friendship here. Probably the biggest unit they have. Will mean we have a pretty easy lethal over really two turns if the Blade's Edges. Would be the fastest way to end this one. Attack. 8-6, they have no ways to interact with this. Just go for Blade's Edge into Blade's Edge.
I am stronger than the darkness within me.
Cards here. Next Blade's Edge. And two dice. This. GG. Okay, here, early game units are always great. We don't really want this 6-cost guy with his dance swaps, which are early game cards usually, or just removal spells. Ground Slam is a removal spell if you have a landmark. I mean, we don't have any landmarks in our deck. Obviously, be terrible. Let's just pick up control. Just for our rewards, we have no rerolls and no healing either. So with this one I kind of like these scout units, because scout you can just buff scout unit up, for example. That's pretty good. This watch is also just a correct champion. We can equip the new skin. Ari homecoming also would be fine. The dancing doppel especially good target with the elusive for me. Then with Ari now a 2-2. Still very powerful with the quick attack challenger and the challenger. I'm going to offer Miss Fortune here, just a very fun champion, and I like playing with her. And also has a 1-drop, 3-drop, 4-drop, so definitely decent. Fade is fine, I don't like pick a card. You can pick up Twisted Fade if you want. I'm going to do Miss Fortune. Here you always want to go for the item, not the coins, you don't really need the shop, you only have 150 gold. And choose which way we want to go. I think last time I went with Kato and Shirasa. Go for the Jacket Butcher here. Better. Jacket Butcher has a bunch of random units in this deck. And has this power, all units have Plunder, grant me +1. Let's head into the fight for our opening hand. Like the drop here. Those one drops my early game. One starts with one random crystal already. Blocker here would not take any. Elric in hand, we get our Fate's Edge. Rolls with the Jailbreak, we can get down. Better to play out our there here. Block it. Elf explode. Then we can just run out the Blast Conceal. Attack Trigger. Are on our way. Attack this better here. Wait for something, that's totally fine. Ah, we can. This. Powder cake. Clear off. Great, deal damage. And have still have control over the board. Follow it up with his watchin. Equip the skin yet. Don't know how it doesn't auto equip the skin. Bad. Do that as soon as possible. A little bit annoying. Could just give up this headshot course there. Great with the watchin. Actually, like just equipping. That's this way that I don't have a good attack. Pass. Fine. Off. One drop. Drop seems best. The cheaper one first. And we can. Capture here. Quite annoying. Not the end of the world. I'm one of the good guys. Watching. Heck. Keep trying. These triggers, the ones in combat, resolve first. They when allies attack triggers, so watching that attack first. And then the Greg shot goes there afterward. Ali. Vent this area here. Actually, spaceship. Put this on the stack and will auto pass for us. Deck our record goes there. Out Yumi attached. And. Nothing like the stink of glory sweat. Wait, by the way, misfortune here. Want to take any damage? We sacrifice one of our record goes there. Yeah, control chest into. Good. Find some interaction. Verbal. A combat trick. Let us take a push at life beneath the waves. I go wherever the waves take me. Catch. Big guy. Heck with it. Deep breath now. Locks, yes. Fine. Not cool. And no, no. Struggle, yeah. It's on the board, that's probably what you have to look out for. Some early game. I'm gonna put the Yumi onto. Like a Radiant Soul, for example. Here we have just the Hush target. Perfect. Run out our Fortune. And just Hush exclusive. Well, over that, that's fine as well. We can just bury it now. That has the last breath effect. Touch of the area. And we can open attack for lethal. But never saw a real play. Art. Yeah. As you can see, then in combat is when all attack triggers resolve from left to right. Click on, there first, other quick triggers there and then watching. And yeah, that's the battle down. Jacket Butcher, not really scary. Definitely easier fight, I would say, from the two. And for our battle rewards, we have the choice between 3 mana, 2-2, we don't have many Celestial cards in our deck at all, don't think we have any. The 3 mana 2-2 with the support ability, Lecturing Yordle with Boarding Charm, so Spell Shield, or Pain with the Ardent Sensor, which buffs in the deck. I think the Pain is actually the best option. We don't really have any hard removal yet for a potential Gangplank or Dane, so just having this detain is an option. Gigantic unit that they can't kill. But Pearl would be okay. Dane just stronger. We only have like 250 gold, so no real point to go to the shop. Go for the item chest. And don't really need spell sheet on a Blast Con Seedling. Okay, it's the thermal totem, but this is a card. So valuable. I will put another control chest in my deck though. But nodes, Pyron. Ooh, let's watch a special one. And we have a reverse row. Want to see the misfortune special one, the Siren. Go for the top fight. Vision Marauder can snowball out of control if you don't have a powerful stuff to do. Marauders just keep coming and keep growing. Definitely want prepared. You want own powerful lands going on. And yeah, jump right into it. Hey, here we definitely want some of our early game. I also like maybe the Detain, but probably should seem good enough. We want to find our Yumi, our powerful cards, exactly like down the Detail Roller. And down this Jailbreak guy in the first turn. Go for it. Flashing Snapper. Great Edge. Very, very valuable power in this Tank Tank level. Always comes in handy to have these 1 damage pings. Can go for Control Chests and put onto it. And just a bit awkward to. I think we kind of have to take 2 damage here, a bit unfortunate. Front seems super strong.
What wondrous discovery
yeah, let's up. Another unit. One, bit annoying. I think we have to let it happen. Take a Yumi. Up afterwards. Mad. Just block everything, you would fall behind too much on the board. Buffling effect comes. Power. One. Block here. And take out the Legion Marauders with our control. Even for the other guys, I got this fight. We have the Blade's Edge. Poor guy, misfortune now. Block Edge. I can just play our Miss Fortune. Don't really have any good action for her. Beautiful skin. Heartbreak as well. It's like recovered by this cannon randomly. And this these parts of the boards weird, right? And you don't really need to open attack our units first. All is done first. Right. Strengthen numbers, which are 2 Legion Marauders. Each shuffles in parts. What I mean with like you have to be aggressive, you have to do something. Better Contrologist. Deck down I Roder in the pinch. Best card. Challenger. Attack and attack. One. Look at the other one, it just dies to watch and last tap. Don't do that. We have a barrier still for our unit to more marauders this turn. One skewers. Blood for blood. Okay. Take down this Legion Marauder. Okay. It's worth something. This one is okay. Take down blood for blood. One. Copy. Guy here. Anything. House action. Oh, I forgot that if it doesn't survive, it doesn't get copied. Yeah, I want to do get my Papercraft Dragon online. No need to open my tech. Like that, we have a Challenger. If they play more Legion Marauders, it's totally fine with us. Care about that. Open my tech here. Our tech with our 2 units. Not a rush or anything. So play it safe. Good by Yumi. As animation, I always like the tower hit by Origami. Take out all of the opponent's units. Flip. And Seedling, if you can. had our fast sprout looking for a life gain guy. Life gain guy, let's just fill here. Just keep. And to Nexus, why not? Going through the motions at this point. In our next attack. Buff. Powerful rider comes out. We care about that, that's just Nexus. Challenge something. Destroy it. Hit Growth Dragon on. Die randomly. Yeah, that just. That logical challenge. I'm going to save my misfortune here. Stunt. Take down misfortune. Again. Double strikers. Could be super lethal. Yeah, Leech Marauder. As long as it's some kind of plan, not just stalling around doing nothing. Usually an easy and very manageable fight. Sure, the other fight is also possible. The other fight has a lot of unavoidable damage with the powder monkeys. Oftentimes a little bit scarier. I would advise if you have a good deck, semi-good deck, just one. If you have a bad deck, you might have another one. Generally just go fine here. Okay, we have some healing phase. Last spring, damage or destroyed heal next equal to cost, so it's just a 2 mana heal 2. That's actually not terrible. A 3 mana 3-4 with the runs to the 3 spell mana, also not terrible. Really like the double up. Don't really care about the Nexus damage, we can just kill our opponents, whatever. And 5 mana deal to damage, even if it shuffles extra copies into our deck, it's just a bad ratio. 2 mana deal to damage or 3 mana deal to damage, 5 mana deal to damage. Do you want the healing here, or do we just want? I think it's pretty close because I don't really like this card that much. If as a 3-4, it's better. Probably we just have to take the unit here. Worth it to up this the health. Because we will never really win with Starspring. Probably pretty close actually. Let's go for the save. What the Siren has in store for us. Oh, we just get the Siren. Two pretty interesting abilities. Elusive, useful somewhat. Summon captures this enemy, that's very strong against Gangplank. Also, minus 2 cost is strong as well. Siren draws your misfortune, and while it's attacking, all your spells and, spells and skills deal extra damage. Really want to pick that up here. I think the extra, the minus cost is just the most useful on this one. Late game deck, and we take our healer for health back. Head into the Bane encounter. Bane is just a big Noxus deck, Noxus curve, however, he doesn't have any spells to interact with you, just deals direct damage to you. Some fake shapes, some answers for the Bane and the other big units we have in our deck. Bane now, Siren, Challenger, no, we didn't have a Challenger, we just approached this early game. Pretty sure we can beat Bane up here, see how we do. Okay, we have a 1-drop, perfect, we don't need our 5-cost cards. For Yumi, for our Misfortune. For late game, for later on. And again, very good to have these ones, let's pass for now. And just play that the jailbreak. Pull it down, don't play out anything, that's fine. Last consulting here. As long as the body holds a Bane, interesting. I'm going to go for the barrier here. If they want to attack me, fine. Daybreak, what 1-drop do they roll? 1-1 elusive, let's put this down right away. Don't want to hit it by these elusives. Nerf the Poro before it starts growing. Don't attack because we have barrier. And now we can play the Umi. We have one big guy. And just basically there's no way for opponent to ever kill this. We're going to attack here. A little bit bad, but fine, if like, you don't really care about Yumi. Yumi never dies, we just trade our 2-drop for both of their units. Blade's Edge can deal with it. Have to take out the other one now. They are Contrologist first. They will stun our guy here. Double Travel. Also not bad, just the book. Alter. Value. I activate second clause, but focus enough. And just block. Go for the attack. No real reason to run out our Bow Fly here. We have the spell mana this turn. This is the turn where they play out Swain. And I actually want them to play out Swain and to trade into my 6-3. Because it might be annoying if I don't do it. Just attack. Stop the trade here. Let's go for the block. That's a file, now it's at 3 health. Going to play out one fast sprout here. Lifesteal guy, here it is, Tasty Fair Folk, that's the one I'm talking about. That's why this fast sprout is very good. Overfly. Do that much. Burst Bellmanner. The one. 6 out of 12. Comes a Legion Veteran. Going to play out my unit here and go for the friendship block. This right now. My head. Back into it. No attack. Fine. Okay, and Double Strike is perfect for our lifesteal guy. They have no way to deal with this ever. Basically won the game. Done it for one turn, that's fine. For some cards, maybe have a revenant flock on our guy or this guy. A bunch of emotes coming at us. Level 12. Level up next turn. Going. I think I want to prevent. Little unit. Could prevent this with like a friendship or something. Better to rest. Let the last way level up. Then block it next. Got it. Done. Oh, he's like permanent emoting. We're gonna find our Yordle book. Find your Yordle book, Yumi. And yeah, they'll just go for the block or something. Okay. Can now invoke. Up like a meteor shower to kill Bane. Perfect. Do this right now. First Bane Manor anyways. Transforms. That's not limited. Now it's around it, it's such a good idea. Yeah, we can. Where are they? Going to take this out over it because they really like challenging my Pogo and jerks about it. Out. Can't really attack here. Yeah, the Navigator. M guy, interesting. I can just fully heal up without double strike. Same guy. Also actually open attack here. Out guy. Doesn't seem to that. There is damage. Revenus. Fine. Oh no, that stuns me. What? Oh, I forgot. Hey, okay, fast sprout coming in. Telescope. Baron seems okay. Back to Equinox though. Left the cheap guy. And put pain on the stain. Have my units stun next turn. Just be able to block. And these are stunned. Back with these. This one maybe. The dog that we can man target down with our looping telescope next turn. Return me to the sea. Watchin gets the buff. 8-8. Get the buff on our other card and then now does 5. Yeah, Miss Watchin out. A capture basically. This is a and just friendship area. But the other guy, I know what I'm doing. nothing anymore. I have one death sand in the deck. You have to remember. No interaction with the guy on the board. The wheel of war turns ever onward. The unit here. The battlefield must stay with Blue Gear. And let's just attack. Isn't to develop anymore. Infinite amount of damage. Show them our cunning skill by taking out the unit. Let's scale. And yes, Vayne is super easy if you have some kind of life gain. If you don't have any life gain at all, it can be a little bit tricky. See it that big of. Okay, here you have the big life gain card in the treasure trash. Actually not terrible. And mana, heal 10, and get some random cards in your hand, that's actually good. Later levels, just having this big heal available, entrapment does nothing, you don't need buff caps or the button sensor. Faker's Gate is another decent option. I think I'm just going to go for the big heal. I really value these health potions and heal effects because you can screw up, you can make mistakes, take some damage, and heal all up late. Might seem very expensive, but trust me, it's worth it. And for our power, here, cafe. Ooh, wow, what are these powers? Straight up, stole the powers. Warfly has spell shield, you have faded, attacked barrier, attack. Yes, no. Let me get plus one, plus one for edge. Gator, go fish. I also really like Feral Senses, just the ability to basically set up your draws each turn. Very powerful, its offense is great. 1% for each keyword is also just a lot of stats. Not sure which one of these like your epic powers, you don't see them that often usually. I'm going to go for the Feral Senses here. However, that's just like draw manipulation. Take the extra. We need to go for healer, go bottom for the coins. The officer, you have this mini game where you just have to shoot down the barrels over and over. Yeah, pretty easy fight. Let's jump in. Okay, one drop, two drop, three drop. For detain, we don't really need that. Probably should have removed our one drop as well. Busy bringing all the guys down for now. We get this knock him down, which is a slow deal one, and we have a fast deal one. Units, hot key specs with pass faster. Really annoying if you have different hotkey profiles. Oh, legend. Go. Yeah, there are controllers. 1 plus 1 with the Hulk attack. Single combat is a very good card here. Legend Broker is fine. And we block us. And just go for Miswatch next turn, or just play the Powerfly and the Pings, depending on what they do, even like purchase. But okay, I'm just going to take that out. But right now, though, because they will usually play one spell mana and kill this, Unseen Form seems fine. Fight is super easy. Now we actually bait them. Direct Dredgers is fine. Building cards to take down these barrels. Can't really do anything against them. Hey, okay, block. Your units. Take them. Yeah, I'm pretty stupid sometimes. But stupid. And another miss watching here. And still have our Van Mana open. Got our units. Fine. Our Corsair as well. He's on damage. Don't want to be here forever. And change this one. Clear off. Actually, deal some damage to Miss Fortune now, but you can protect her for one turn. Friendship. And put a Yugi onto her. That would have been the best play to give my Miss Fortune one health. Doesn't really matter in the end, this fight is super. Go for it. So let's just buff up Miss Fortune, make sure you don't die. Block. Longer block. Ballert mein Power Flight Block. And just split as well, das ist wie Autopass. Attack again, ping again. Geht es dann mit Combat? Never seen them cast these sleeper fishes before. That's actually pretty bad, our Siren. Pretty good. Now we can go for the Scarlet Attack. Two damage, another one tilt spell. And let's make take out one blocker first. Around here, or like, take out the blocker. In this turn, possible. In that gets possible. Go for the typical attack. Watch the level up next combat. Yeah, shoot it down. Cool to Nexus. Perfekt. The interesting that there's no overwhelm attached guy. Made sense for like Targon maybe. Maybe that would have been strong. It's Dragon, das hier. Attach. The unit's big. Powder, we will shoot down. Wait for now, they probably go for some kind of play. Down. You can see the sweet watch and level up. Well. Game. They never used this knocking down on Nexus, that's pretty nice programming. Pretty annoying, just 3 pinged here over and over randomly. Attack, level up. No regrets, no mercy. Really like this animation. Perfect. Really like, I'm not a big fan of these arcane skins in general. This one is nice. And especially this heart in the middle. And GG. Healing, more healing is perfect. We need a 4-8. Okay, but healing. All we ever. Go for the gold chest. Gold. And the item shop. I actually like the draw one effect on this one and on this one as well. First one you can do is buy a token and it shows you what other things you have. So you probably go to bottom here with the item and just spend all of our money. This. I'm actually going to use my reroll here as well. Double heal is perfect. Heal 20. Area doesn't really do that much. Just whatever. And head on to Riptide Rex. First time we will fight this one. Deals 2 to any unit randomly. A little bit annoying, but mostly kills its own stuff. Some new stuff. If you look at the deck list, it's just a big old swarm deck. Random Bilgewater units. That's not really that threatening. Jump in and see. Okay, we will just look for our early game units. Early game units. All more than more. Precious is nice. Now. Delay 3-3 and no reason to Nexus. Hail break. One quest guy. Also no reason to ping this one because at round start it did damage a random thing, remember? Just shoot it down themselves. Invest any resources into it. And let's just run out control chest. Manage resolve seems okay. Astounding curiosities lie. We have our blades edge open. On the random guy they get. Good random guy to get. I'm going to block here then, prevent the damage. And then this gets shot at the run start with that trigger. A little bit of a problem here is if you just play out fortune, gets pinged, and then gets pinged again and dies. I'm going to wait here for a little bit. See what they do. Hurry. Run down. And find our Yumis and stuff before we deploy our units here. Perfect, here's Yumi. Dangerous waters. A little bit annoying, but not the end of the world. This Block hier. And we have our heal 20 anyways, so it doesn't really matter what damage we take. I will just clear the board here. Wait around for too long. Just 50-50. Clear the board, I will run out of stuff pretty fast. Yeah, let's just Siren here. Big beef unit, 4-8. We have 2 misfortunes in the deck, unfortunately. Not a purposeful joke. Spell attack. Again.
My life or theirs.
And run them out of stuff. Eventually we will just heal for 20 if we have a big board setup. For the card draw here, 14 cards left, hooked help. Fortunate. We'll do that because of a Blade's Edge here, saving our misfortune. On Matrix, that one Bilge Water. And put on our item, our Yumi and our misfortune.
Wait, you've been following me?
Perfect. And yeah, let's just go for the misfortune level up. As well, we can actually play out our Scout unit first. I don't really have anything good to do here. Get our Fallen Feline, schaff es in der Exiled Crystal. Cost 2, draw 2. Win. Barrage. Doesn't really do that much either. Just a little bit. We have done for the Magic Result here. Doesn't really matter. Then just. I am up, I guess.
Wondrous discoveries await below.
Oh, why did I pass? Oops. My bad. Wanted to attack, of course. And I just clicked okay. Doesn't really matter. Just have 4 cards left in the deck, so I'm on decking them out as well. And I'm pretty confident no longer taking damage here, so I'm just going to heal for 20. Can find some fun cards to play out. Yeah, we can play out all 3 of those. Down. Elnok. Armentovs.
Looking into the future, I see purple.
And just open attack here. Down. Out attack. Sorry, block. Block. I think the fastest way is just to mill them out at this point. We need to play any cards, just wait around. Do something we can. There is. Full Elnok. Vulnerable, that's fine. Down in Pogo. Not that much happening at this point. Moon version. 5, so we can play out Ayumi, that's just an anomaly. All the spells. Just don't challenge this. Okay, okay, so we will just detain this. Save all of our units. No, now misfortune gets obliterated. We have no board space left over. If misfortune gets resummoned, it gets obliterated. So we misfortune. Once again, let's just mill our opponent out. Just smart at, fast at this point than like hacking. So it pass, opponent is programmed to pass back. But let's have 0 cards in deck now. If you have 0 cards in your deck, lose. Or like fatigue or anything like that. Okay, 1 drops. More. Gain some more.
Where do you stand on cold shots?
Ration attack. Fuck. We don't take any damage. Stay. Actually faster to play out a unit here, so not have the ration go up. war die Hard Milling. And GG, Opponent on to Gangplank. Hey, play, I saw the free attack is very, very good with Miss Fortune. The Ephemeral is actually also pretty good because a Papercraft Dragon or a attached card doesn't transfer Ephemeral. Just have +3/+3. Negative Keywords like Ephemeral don't get transferred with attach. It's also pretty, very good upgrade. So I prefer the Fortune build around and the free attack. And for our item, and some Scout or something. Ooh, Elusive is great with our free attack guy. Also very good focusing crystal for a bunch of spells. We don't really have that many spells, just some. Elusive on our character cost is just insanely good here. We have nothing to heal, so we head into Gangplank. We will just have to see and make sure we can deal with Redway, either with our Pains, we have 3 copies of it, or Fortune Challenger stuff. I'm pretty confident that we can do it. We have 5 times insane character cost in our deck. Let's just head into the fight. Perfect, we start with our insane 1-drop. Just need to find Miss Fortune now. We're very happy. Actually, don't really want to play this out turn 1. Actually, better to hold this until we find Miss Fortune. 5 of those. We just play it out now and block even. We are like bigger because. Okay, and Fortune Rating Room. We only have 2 Miss Fortunes, or Yumi Rating Room as well. They might have, the Naked Rain and kill both of our units. That was a pretty battle unit. Have it. Good for us. Take out these arrows. Damage, don't want to end the goal too low. Under 20 just yet. This is very good. The Blade's Edge, you can counter any kind of shenanigans with the Powder Keg set. Ah, the Blizzard Wizard, why not? Nothing. I have a lot of very expensive cards, like 6 of them, 6 8 drops, so it's quite usual to have nothing for them. And let's just go for the Ear Attach. And attack all. Still is not blocking at all. Bit annoying. Go for the nap plus warning shot. Pass here. Reason to stand our other guy and deal more damage. That we want to just preserve our units. We have a answer to Gangplank. We have a Blade's Edge here. And just pass here for now, we attack here. Bring 2-3 to me. Get the press uptick. Line him up. Okay. Dann ist der IS just random cards. Take the Gangplank down. Need to protect our guy. Like to get my units down, let's just play our Iron Navigator here. Yun also counting the keyword for you. And yeah, cover something. Cover effect happens first. We can play Hulk. Afterwards. I think it's just visually. Hello. Air Hulk is just very, very strong here. Biggest problem is that don't really have an answer for the Dreadway yet. However, I think they will go for a block eventually if I'm going for these aggressive attacks. Force this block to happen. Have a block like that. Oh. You'll fight or you'll swim. Less than 20 health. I think I wait 1 turn here. Set up my resources a little bit before I go for the red wave. But what's the worst that could happen? Oh yeah, what's the worst that could happen? Same as last words. You poor thing. Such a big board lead. Take that out of the board, at Redway, Gangplank, but 1 out of 5 level up, totally fine. Block of a game for the Redway, Gangplank out of the deck. Powder Keg. Eat. Powder Keg related with our Blade's Edge. Tap my treasured trash. Okay. 220 for them. Expected twist of events. And yeah, just play our Hippocraft Dragon. Life Steal guy, so we can never die. The Raw Duelist. Ein. And Volt and Deck comes in. Actually annoying that he gets the Challenger because all of these units deal extra damage. Like this, you should. What units should survive? Normally, the red way always attacks on the left, and you can just block it with some random guy. This time, for our Surgist. Rush is pretty nice. What wondrous discoveries await below. Blade's Edge. Peril. Open attack again. He levels up, perfect. We're gonna find our Yordle book. And watching you here, they got jump block. Bit dirty. Yes, Umi feels super strong for now. Even seems easier than Gangplank to run. I honestly opinion. Have these super strong hits. Augment your deck about any good champion. Make all of your other rest of your deck go around it. Remember to march for which card to play, doesn't really matter. Do to shoot down these barrels again. Ember fish up, up. Use V for example. All cat, why not? Play all the cards. And these fights just take a little bit, because we don't have these OP insane late game cards. Their bones are splinter. Prank coming in now. Where did they get a prank from? Oh my treasure trap. Well, the siren here find our misfortune finally. Fine. How about that? And we can just now play out our misfortune and level up next. Right next turn, but. Right, our guy here. Gives us all of the triggers in the world. Laser guns. Hit. Attack. Sing them their doom. And attack. We win it here, so we don't challenge the barrel anymore. You got legs. And perfect. Basically, GG. They prevent him from my S here with the Phantom Block. Pretty stupid from the AI. Annoying. Ever. Didn't really care about the S. 29 health is same as 30. We have it recorded. Phase. And yeah, this was Gangplank. Pretty easy, pretty solid with Yumi. Pick up your big guys. Use your fair thing to get your lifesteal. And be done with any board champion. Rerolls. F. Tank up ready. Tank her up. Medic chest. Call it a day. Reroll. Starting item. Same all the time. This is the rally world with medical rewards. Big fan of Tall Tales actually, but I have to take the stalking wood here. Giving your opponent these no hairs and medic just so generous. Hey, Shadow Elvira. All Tales. Fucking wohl. And let's conclude it for today's episode of Path of Champions playthrough. Back in tomorrow when we next level.